So friends, very warm welcome. We should Thomas 11, dear friends, and each and every one of you there. If a project like this gone back, we will come back again. And each and every one of you for this very, very important session on end of life care and palliative care. As just to put this, to situate this whole session as we are journeying these last few days, we are actually dealing with the healing ministry of Jesus Christ. So that is our focus, that is our goal, that is our mission, that is our mandate. Proclamation of the gospel and the evangelizing mission of the church. And we realize that all that we are doing these 3 days there is having that central focus, central goal, central purpose. As you know, the church, especially the church in India, through its institutions, its hospitals, its centers, its healing centers, healthcare centers, it is a very strong witness of what actually it means to be church. And this part of healing ministry is a very essential ministry. In the words of the popes and the words of the teaching of the church, central to the church's life and ministry. So therefore, many of us here who are involved in healthcare apostolate there, is doing a very, very vital service to people, especially the poor, especially the marginalized, especially the suffering and the dying. And as you know that today the number of dying people are growing because human life expectancy is going up there, and number of people living longer is increasing. And that's why the challenges here of end of life care and palliative care become even more, because the human body is still living on. Some of the organs are getting weak, and because of that, the question is, you know, the length of life, the longevity of life, and the care that is given to them. So therefore now, in that perspective, and with the perspective of many countries now, legally permitting physician-assisted suicide, and also consenting adults who are enduring physical or mental suffering, asking for medical intervention, terminate their lives, we have this so-called secular concepts coming and creeping into society versus the church, who has a great gift, the church's teaching on life, the sanctity of life, the gift of life from the very first moment of conception till the end of life, till natural death. That is the position of the church. So how we see that integrated into end of life care and palliative care, we have here with us our two very well known speakers. We have Dr. Pascal Carvalho there, doctorate in microbiology, postdoctorate in immunology from the WHO fellowship, director, technical services, Accurex Biomedicals, nominee, committee for the purpose of control and supervision of experiments on animals, Ministry of Environment and Forests, member of Indian Society of Blood Transfusion, immunohematology member of Board of Studies, microbiology, St. Xavier's College, Mumbai, head diagnostic business, Pyramid Healthcare Limited, consultant to biotechnology industry research, etc., co guide, IIT, MTech, students of biomedical engineering, and so on and so forth, faculty for food and drug administration, officer's training program. So much he's done, but one, the most important, he's the member of the Pontifical Academy of Life for a number of years, 9-10 years there, Vatican City, giving the churches a perspective there, what's happening in India on all life issues. Dr. Pascal Carvalho, a good friend of mine, a very, very warm welcome to you, for this beautiful session. Please give a warm welcome. I please also now that we have presentations simultaneously after that. Dr. Maryam Rodagan, Master's degree in Radiotherapy, MSc in Palliative Medicine, Cardiff University, UK, and EPEC Master Facilitator for Pediatrics and India Northwestern University, Chicago, United States of America. She's worked at the Tata Memorial Center in Palliative Care for integration of palliative care into the trajectory of illness as early as possible for patients with life-limiting conditions, and families involved very much into palliative care, palliative medicine for a number of years. She was heading that department there in Tata Memorial for how many years? 20 years, managing palliative care. So very special expert in the field. Please give her a very, very warm welcome. And now, without much ado,